Welcome to another book review, and we're going to review Puck Me by Elise Kelly. This book follows Alex and Chloe. They're kind of romance. I would say this is more of a brother's best friend type of romance with a hockey theme, obviously. Main characters are Alex and Chloe. Taylor is best friends with Alex, Chloe's older brother. There you go. Alex's character is basically the playboy, professional athlete type of the New York Storm hockey team. He's the defenseman, but like all-around star, mostly in the public, tabloids and all that, yada, yada, yada. Chloe is like kind of like the down-to-earth type of girl, you know, friends with the guys type of vibe. She is the only one who basically doesn't kneel to Alex. They've met briefly before, but like not to the point where Alex really noticed her. Their meet cute is basically he's rushing out of the locker room, and this is after a conversation that he has with Taylor about, you know, I'm tired of, you know, dealing with puck bunnies. I kind of just want, you know, something solid, something real. I have that conversation with Taylor. He bumps into Chloe rushing out of the, walking out of the locker room. And, you know, he kind of like is in awe of her because she's like looking around him, not looking at him. She's looking for a brother, not really looking for him. He's used to girls just fawning over him and falling all over him. So this is kind of refreshing. Instantly, he's attracted. With that being said, Chloe, you know, she's an adult, she has a job, you know, she's not really into, obsessing over hockey players. I mean, her brother is a hockey player, so she's been around that kind of life. So in this very thin book that I could tell was supposed to be purely a Kindle read, but like, I never really like, Kindle reads. I have a Kindle, but I really don't use it because I like to read whenever I want to and not being like limited to the battery of a Kindle. So I love hard copies. So this book took me, honestly, a total of 6 hours, I guess you could say, to finish. That's my only downfall. I feel like this book could have been like a 10 out of 10 if it would have had more, you know, time. Because at first she goes for being hard to get. This is not a spoiler. This is everything you can get from the back if you just read it. She plays hard to get, and then of course Alex being persistent, his goal is, I don't want her to see me as this playboy hockey player. I want her to see me for me, and I'm really interested in having an actual relationship with her. Chloe, of course, being like kind of down to earth and relaxed and chill, she also has self-esteem issues. That's the kind of thing I did not like about her character. You can't be this, you know, like, I don't need a man, that type. Not even that. She can't be that type of, like, independent, chill, I'm a girl of the guys, like, kind of friend. And then have these severe self-esteem issues where you don't think you're good enough for him. That's what she gives me when I read it. She's like, oh, you know, I'm not like all those other girls fawning over you. But then as soon as she realizes he's showing interest, she's like, oh, he just wants to, you know, get me in bed. He doesn't really want to be with me. It just didn't match. It didn't match the persona to me. But I mean, there's all kinds of girls in the world. There's all kinds of guys in the world. But it just didn't fit because, like, he wasn't giving that kind of vibe. He, you know, made the effort to, like, talk to her and actually try to get to know her and, you know, took the proper precautions of talking to her brother before he approached her to see if it was okay. And so it just seems like kind of a moment when, you know, they're within their interactions, you see she's so self-conscious. I'm like, this didn't fit. I love the supporting characters. I mean, the supporting character of Alex was Taylor. And, of course, Chloe had her little friends. But it just seemed like it was rushed. The book's so thin, it seems like everything was rushed. Even the point, even the climax point seemed rushed. I do like the way it ended. How it ended, it didn't leave me wanting to find out what happened next. The only thing that I got from the end of it is I wish there was more context. Like, you know, you get the perspective of Alex, you get the perspective of Chloe, but I didn't get enough of their perspectives to kind of understand why they were doing the things that they were doing. I guess it kind of needed a little bit of a backstory. It just seems everything was so rushed. It's like they met each other, bam, 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 the end type of thing. So with that being said, the spice, one being a kiss, 10 being like intense, I would say the spice level is a good 6 because when it was there, it was like chef's kiss, coup de grace. But if I had to just rate the book entirely, like would I read it again? Maybe. Would I suggest others to read it? Yeah, I mean, it's a good book, but it's a good book for someone who's trying to get into reading spicy novels and aren't used to reading books, per se. So they're like, usually when I read books, I don't finish them. This would be a good book to suggest to someone who's really getting into reading romance novels and don't know if they have the time to put forth in said romance novel, if that makes sense. But Puck Me by Elise Kelly was a good book. I was going through a writer's drought where I didn't know what I wanted to read, and I had remembered that I did like the last hockey themed book that I read, which was The Deal. So if you read The Deal and you liked it, read Puck Me. Thanks for watching. I hope you subscribe.